the members, I have some observation to make, and I would try to appeal to all the members who are present, not present, to take notice of what I am saying. From the day I have assumed the office of chairman of this august house, I have made it clear that any issue sought to be raised by any member of the house will be allowed to be raised, provided if there is a proper notice is given and it is as per the rules. I have reasons to believe that no honorable member would have any grounds in this regard. I am deeply concerned with the negative public perception of this august house on account of forced adjournments, and that too quite frequently over the years, which frequently follows a pattern aimed at not allowing the house to function smoothly, come what may. Ever since I started chairing the proceedings of this house, leaders of several parties have conveyed their anguish to me over how they are being deprived of their right to raise some of their concern, and so as some parties strategically for disruptions leading to forced adjournment. I have shared this with floor leaders on many occasions. I know that many of the members, some of them are here, some of them are not there, from the back benches, they came and met me and told me, sir, after the main parties they speak, they don't allow the house to function, then we are deprived of an opportunity to put forth our point of view. That have really made me to seriously think that we must also find out a way. Secondly, the pattern of disruptions, I would like to share with the honorable members that I have admitted a total of 42 zero-hour admissions during the last 3 working days, 2nd, 5th and 6th of this month. Who is to be held responsible for denying 41 members of their right to bring their concerns to the notice of this august house and to the government? Even yesterday, the entire house saw in the zero hour, when I started taking up zero hour, there were disruptions, and as insisted by the member who has given notice, I allowed the honorable member to make his submission in the zero hour. He tried his best, but his voice was not allowed to be heard. Who is responsible for the same? So that way, we have also given a trial that you call the members, give some time, and meanwhile, the message goes to the country. I need not explain it, what is happening to the image of this august house. The another aspect of this pattern is that first zero hour is disrupted, and then even question hour, when members get an opportunity to question the government, is also disrupted. The question hour belongs to members. They do a lot of work and then raise questions, and the government also correct information after so much effort. If the question hour is lost, then it is a loss to the house and it is a loss to the country. And I have umpteen number, I don't want to get into those details, occasions where the question hour was not allowed to be taken up in the house. Another aspect is that in many occasions, over the once house gets adjourned several times between 11 and 1 p.m., in this era of TV explosion, such frequent adjournments are adversely impacting the image and credibility of this house. This is where I am concerned. In this backdrop, I thought that it would be better to adjourn the house for a longer period instead of resorting to frequent adjournment, that too when it becomes evident that some sections of the house were bent on not allowing smooth conduct of the house. I can tell you frankly, some of them, they come to me and also tell me openly, sir, today, please, don't misunderstand us. I don't want to name the parties. I have everything with me, including today, including yesterday. And then, when I know that the house is not going to be allowed to function, when people are going to create scenes, I thought it will be in the interest of the house not to see that such unruly scenes are witnessed by the public. That's where I am concerned. There may be difference of opinion. Some people are saying, no, sir, it is democracy. Let this unruly scenes also, all this behavior also go on record, let the people see, and then they decide. There can be one point of view. I don't differ with that. But I have my own strong view as being in the house for years together and being in public life. The image of the parliament, the image of the institutions, other institutions, it has to be kept intact, and it has to be raised. and we have that great parliamentarians who have contributed their might to the country by meaningful debates in this house and also in other houses. So I am very much concerned on that personally. Some of you who have been discussing with me also know what is my concern. My concern is not confined to a parliament, Rajya Sabha alone. And I go to public functions also, I open up my mind and also tell the people this should not happen, not about Rajya Sabha, even about, because the assemblies, the municipalities, the Jilla Parishads, the local bodies, they look to the top institutions, parliament, Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, and other institutions. So we should not allow the image to go down. We have seen yesterday one observation made by one of the judges of the Supreme Court with regard to what is happening in Supreme Court. I don't want to recall that. So that being the case, the idea is to protect the image and stature of the parliament. So my intention in adjourning it for a longer period is that I want everybody to understand the seriousness and also the concern of mine. Today morning I shared my concern along with the deputy chairman and also with some of the floor leaders who are there in the house, my chamber. I urged the leaders to ensure smooth conduct of proceedings. I also told the leaders that if house proceedings were disrupted at the start, I would be left with no option but to adjourn the house till lunch. I made very clear. My intention in doing so is to promote a sense of collective responsibility in minimizing or doing away with such forced frequent disruptions. When members and parties realize they would ultimately be the losers of such disruptions and adjournments, they would like to talk to each other and enable better functioning of the House. I realize some honorable members have perhaps not properly understood my concern and anguish over the functioning of this House. I would like to reiterate again that it would be my commitment to allow any issue to be raised by anybody as per the rules. I have a weakness and a commitment to the rules, to the procedures, to the dignity of this House, and I am keen that I should stick to that. My commitment to allow any issue to be raised by anybody as per the rules and procedures, nobody should have any misgivings about that. All the 0-hour submissions, whichever is coming to me, some of them are not really in the purview of the central government. Some are concerned with the state government. But I thought the member want to raise it in the House. Okay, let it be raised. And sometimes, you know, I used to insist the minister also to respond. Though in 0 hour, there is no such a responsibility on part of the government to respond immediately. They can send it later. Why I'm sharing this is, I'm told some members have gone out and expressed their views. I don't want to join issue with them because as the chairman, that's not my thing. But I thought it's my responsibility to share with the country, to share with the members what is happening here. We should all see to it that the House functions effectively. House functions constructively. Protest, there is a forum of protest. And also criticism. We have seen yesterday how people spoke on President's address from this side and from that side. Very eloquent speeches were made. Very strong criticism was made. I have nothing to lose, nothing to choose, this way or that way. I want only to house function and also function as per parliamentary conditions and traditions. That's why I want to make it very clear on the floor of the House. Friends, I would like to call Mr. Law Ganeshan now.